All right, everyone, welcome to the virtual college exploration for all West Virginia students, sponsored by the West Virginia Association of Collegiate Registrars and Admissions Officers and StriveScan. Thank you for joining us. A few housekeeping announcements before we get started. You can use your Q&A button on your screen to type your questions to our presenters at any time. Your camera and microphone are off, so the panelists cannot see or hear you. This is just one of the many different sessions happening, so be sure to check out the full schedule at WVACRAO.org. This presentation is being recorded and will be available within a week at that same website, WVACRAO.org. I'd like to now turn it over to our presenters.
Good evening, and thank you for joining us to learn more about West Virginia University. We are going to be using Kahoot tonight, so if you have a smartphone or device that you're able to use to play along, you may want to get that handy now.
This is West Virginia University, home of Mountaineers. We're talking like real Mountaineers, none of that fake stuff.
A West Virginia Mountaineer.
Of champions, pioneers, record breakers, scholars. And this is our jam. We're home to the largest crime scene training complex in the country. The first institute in the world devoted to studying human memory. And we're making headlines in all these places too. This is WVU, where we do the highest level research, seeking cures, building hope, hunting pulsars, discovering new technologies, proving Einstein's theory. Wait, this list just keeps going. You don't expect me to read all these, do you? This is WVU, where being unique and proud of it is in the blood, where he can find rhythm and engineer his future, where she can compete on the field and on the stage, and where our president can inspire us to be ourselves, which is a pretty good thing to be, where a little grit and determination can literally take you anywhere. I'm gonna go flying. This is WVU, a family of distinct campuses, just a short drive from here, here, and here. Where a degree opens doors for anyone and anywhere, where you can dig into your passions, create your own niche, and find your purpose. This is WVU. Our students are realizing their own visions, leading their own adventures, and writing their own stories. Shh, whoa, sorry. I forgot we were in a library. And when you become a Mountaineer, you'll never have to go it alone. Because here, our faculty will challenge you and support you. Your fellow students will push you and encourage you. And our alumni will guide you no matter where your journey unfolds. We're a community that works smart and plays smart. We question assumptions and laugh at obstacles. A place where everyone fits, because we're all in this together. This is West Virginia University. This is home.
So hello, everyone, and thank you again for joining us. We are really excited to tell you a little bit more about West Virginia University. My name is Danielle Ensenbigler. I am one of the regional recruiters who works in the state of West Virginia. So I work primarily with students from Northern West Virginia, North Central, and the Northern Panhandle. I will let my colleague Christina introduce herself.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining. My name's Christina Meyer. I'm a regional recruiter as well at West Virginia University. I primarily work with students from the southern part of the state of West Virginia. I'm excited to speak with you tonight about West Virginia University, as it is also my alma mater, and we look forward to talking with you.
And And hello, I'm Rochelle Davis. I'm also a regional recruiter with West Virginia University, and I work primarily with students in the eastern part of the state, from the eastern panhandle down to Fayette County. And thank you again for joining us this evening. Again, we're going to be using Kahoot. I see that some of you have already joined in, so you know how this works. You're going to go to kahoot.it and enter the game pin that you see on the screen. And we'll give you just a few minutes to get logged in, and then we'll get started with our presentation. If for some reason you're not able to join right away, along the presentation, you're going to see the same information at the lower right of your screen. So you will still have time to join. And thanks to those of you who have already logged into the game. And I think we'll go ahead and get started again. If you'd like to join in progress, you'll have an opportunity to do that. So, Christina, when you're ready, I think we'll begin. We hope this information we share this evening will answer all of your questions, and we will have time for Q&A at the end of the presentation. So again, welcome. And this first question is a poll. So we just want to know who you are. If you're a parent of a prospective student, if you're in the 10th, 11th, or 12th grade, if you could please answer accordingly. You'll pick the color that corresponds to your answer. Mostly seniors, I see. Well, thank you. The next is a question. How many campuses make up the WVU system? And the answer is three. So West Virginia University is statewide. We have a campus in Morgantown. We're primarily going to be talking about our Morgantown campus this evening. But you can also see that we have a location in Kaiser, West Virginia. That is our Potomac State campus of WVU campus, and Beckley campus, which you may know as WVU Tech. So we are statewide. We have about 31,000 students among the three campuses. To tell you a little bit more about our students, we have about 27,000 students at Morgantown. Again, we're going to be talking mostly about Morgantown this evening. And about 21,000 of our students are undergraduate students, so they're pursuing bachelor's degrees. Our students represent all 55 counties in West Virginia and all 50 states, so we're really proud of that. And more than 2,300 international students have joined us from 118 countries. And you can see from the slide that a little more than half of our students are from other states. So we're popular nationwide and in some cases internationally. This is an overview of our Morgantown campus. You can see that we have three areas. You may be familiar with the Evansdale part of campus if you've been to a football game. That's also the home to our College of Engineering. We have a medical campus that is home to Ruby Memorial Hospital, which is a level one trauma center. And then downtown area, the original part of campus, you can see that they're all connected by the yellow ribbon there, and that is our PRT, our Personal Rapid Transit System, which is an above ground monorail system, a very unique mode of transportation to get you around campus. This picture is a nice fall shot of Woodburn Hall in the foreground. In the background, that tall building down the river is our downtown welcome center, our visitor center. Another quiz question for you. So WVU has an R1 research status. How many other colleges and universities do you think also have this designation? And the answer is 130. So we're really proud of this fact. There are about 4,000 colleges and universities in the United States, and only 130 have this designation. So what this means, we do the top level research that's conducted in the United States. So if you're interested in robotics, cancer research, public health, all sorts of different opportunities, even as an undergraduate student, you would work with a faculty mentor who could guide you. There are also paid opportunities. If you want to be part of a research apprenticeship program, you would earn $9 an hour during your course of research. You could also get funding to help fund your projects, and there's opportunities for travel. So be open to the idea of conducting research while you're at WVU. Research opportunities also include prestigious Rhodes Scholar, Truman Scholars, and other prestigious research opportunities.
Right, next quiz question. What is the student to faculty ratio on the Morgantown campus? And the answer is 18 to 1. So, one thing we're very proud of at West Virginia University is we keep small class sizes for our students. That's something we pride on, and that's very important to us. And I hope you were pleasantly surprised by that 18 to 1 student faculty ratio. In fact, over 60% of our classes at West Virginia University are 40 students or less. So keep in mind that at any institution you go to, you might have a few large lecture halls that first year, but at WVU, we really do an awesome job of breaking it down, especially when you get into your program around sophomore year, the more specific courses to your major. Here is a list of our colleges and schools at West Virginia University. So that's how we're able to keep that tight-knit class size for you. As a testament to West Virginia University, my undergrad, I still keep in contact with my faculty members at the Reed College of Media. I still have lifelong friends I made within the program. And one of my first classes freshman year actually only had 16 students when I walked in. So that's something that we pride on at West Virginia University, big opportunity at a family size field. Here are some of our unique majors at West Virginia University. Altogether, system-wide, we offer over 350 different degree programs. In Morgantown alone, we have about 230 degree programs. And then our undergraduate degree programs, which is what you're primarily interested in, we have over 140, not including our hundreds of minors. So this is a list of some of our more unique programs. We encourage you to reach out to us individually for more information about any of our academic programs. The facts, statistics, rankings, research will get you in contact with a faculty member or recruiter from that college. Let us know how we can help you navigate and find your fit at WVU with your academic program. There's a lot of really neat programs at West Virginia University. We're one of the first schools in the nation to offer forensic science. And because of that, the FBI and CIA recruit directly from the program. We have the largest crime research lab in the country. We have an awesome neuroscience program, the first institution of its kind dedicated to the research of human memory, music therapy, sports psychology, you name it. We're all over the map with some of our really awesome academic programs. Again, if you're interested in any certain program, we'll take questions at the end, but also contact us and let us know how we can help you. Here are some of our campus resources, just to name a few. Again, I use the word free, but all this is covered in tuition, room, and board. So these services are free services to students. The Caruth Center has counseling. You can see a psychologist. At Well WVU, we have a health clinic where you can see doctors or nurses if you're not feeling well on the spot. We have a writing center for help. We have tutoring in every class available on campus. It's both in-person, virtual. We have one-on-one group tutoring. We have an Office of Accessibility Services that works with students with learning disabilities or physical disabilities before coming into school and what that would look like for you. We also have a math center that really helps you with any of your math needs. Again, walking in, getting help on the spot. We have MindFit, which is a great program that helps exercise your mind, develops good study habits, good test taking. RISE WVU is for underrepresented students. We have first-gen initiatives for students who are the first to go to school, college, and their family. And we have an awesome career center that helps with resume building, job placement, mock interview trials, what to wear for an interview. So anything to be well, do well, and just stay healthy physically, mentally, any type of way you can think is offered at West Virginia University. We want you to succeed and do well here. Here are some therapy dogs we have running around campus. So if you had a tough day and you had a long test or you just finished studying for a few hours, they're here to cheer you up. You'll see them around campus. My favorite is Ryder. He's a very friendly lab that I see quite frequently when I'm on campus. So another quiz question for you. How many student organizations are on the Morgantown campus? Okay, and the answer is around 480. So we do offer a wide range of student orgs that you can get involved with. You name it, anywhere from cultural, religious, political. We have Greek life, club sports, intramural sports. We even have a Quidditch team that competes against other schools in Harry Potter Quidditch. So you think of it, we have it offered at WVU for you. We also have 17 D1 athletic teams, which we'll talk about a little more later. We have club and intramural sports. So if you're an athlete, but maybe can't play on the D1 level, our club teams compete against D2 and D3 colleges. They still travel and have official coaches. Also, we have an amazing study abroad program. Obviously, things are a little different right now because of COVID-19, but we send over 1,500 students a year to study abroad to over 50 different countries. I had a friend once in when I was back in college that actually studied abroad 4 times at West Virginia University. A week-long program, you could do a semester-long summer program, and there's scholarships too to study abroad. So that's a great resource for you if you want to kind of travel the world a little bit while in school. The Center for Service and Learning has actually won several awards. It is a great office that helps students get engaged with Morgantown community. And we also have what's called WVU Up All Night, where it's every Thursday through Saturday from 9 p.m. to 2 a.m. We have different acts come in every weekend, like a laser tag dome or an ice skating rink. Adventure West Virginia is very unique. It is an outdoor orientation program offered to admitted students. We will send out information usually in February. If you're interested, it's Habitat for Humanity, hiking, whitewater rafting. And we also have an awesome rec center on campus. Indoor rock climbing wall, track, basketball courts, workout equipment. Our university art series is great if you want to see off-Broadway or comedians, music acts, just big names come from all over where you can get tickets and come and experience this. And of course, our theater students put on awesome productions as well. So another quiz question, what's a must-learn song for West Virginia University students? Okay, Take Me Home, Country Roads. If you've ever been to a sporting event, it's a lot of fun to sing that song at all of our games. The Mountaineers are our mascot, and we have an awesome week called Mountaineer Week where we celebrate West Virginia heritage and Appalachian culture. We have events like this happening all the time around campus for our students that really outline our tradition and just some fun things that students can do. We're part of the Big 12 Conference. Of course, tickets are free for students. You do have to reserve a ticket for football and basketball, but if you love sporting events, you can go all year round at West Virginia University, and they're very exciting. Just games and events to go to. If you haven't been to a WVU game, I highly recommend it. It's a lot of fun. So at WVU, what NCAA sports team has won the most national championships? And the answer is Rifle. Sorry, I got stuck there. So our Rifle is our most decorated team. In fact, that's Jenny Thrasher, a gold Olympist from the Rio Olympics. She was a student at the time. We're very proud of her. So home away from home, moving into residence halls, we offer 12 residence halls. As a first-time freshman, you do have to live on campus your first year. But we have different styles for everybody, suite, community, even apartments for first-time freshmen. We also have a self-selection room for a self-selection for room and roommates, that you fill out your housing application, you enter the portal, and you get to navigate and choose your own dorm, your dorm room, and roommates as well of other students that you might be interested in living with. And then of course we have our meal plans, 3 to choose from, just based on the amount you eat, and you can use them at any of the dining options or the restaurants around campus, like Chick-fil-A, Tzatziki's, Starbucks. And we do also have live-learn communities. So if you're interested in living with other students within your academic field, these are some of our live-learn communities that we offer, and they're very popular for students. So we do have this as an opportunity as well.
So if you have liked what you've heard and you decide that you want to apply to West Virginia University, here are a few important details to know. So we do review applications on a rolling basis. And what that means is we don't wait until one date, hold all of our decisions, and then send them out at one time. The earlier you apply, the earlier that you will get a decision back from us. We started sending out decisions last month and will continue to do so until the incoming class has reached capacity. We also want students to know that letters of recommendation and essays are not required, nor are they used in the review process. So we want to make sure that you're not spending extra time on something that's not going to be reviewed. You can choose between 2 applications. We have our WVU application, and we also have the Common App. Students will oftentimes ask us, which do we prefer? We don't necessarily have a preference on our end. The only recommendation we typically give is that you don't use the Common App if you are only using it to apply to West Virginia University. It's going to ask for a lot of additional information than what we actually use in the review process. It's a great tool if you're applying to multiple schools, but if you're applying just to WVU, just go ahead and use the WVU application. If you are applying to certain majors within our College of Creative Arts, there may be a portfolio review or an audition that is required. They will notify you of that after you are admitted. And what's really nice is that audition or portfolio review does serve as your scholarship application to the College of Creative Arts, and they have scholarships up to full tuition available. And then also important to note, some of our programs do have a priority deadline of December 1st. So if you are interested in, say, nursing or dental hygiene, you're going to want to make sure that you apply sooner rather than later. Something that is new this year is that we are allowing students to apply test optional. So COVID-19 has made it very difficult to take standardized tests. We understand that. So we want to make the application process as stress-free as possible. So the first scenario, if you have taken the SATs or ACTs and you want to use those when you apply, you will indicate that no, you do not want to apply test optional. At that point, we need your completed application, your official high school transcript or self-reported transcript, and then your official test scores. You will automatically be considered for both academic scholarships and certain academic programs, depending on what you've indicated on the application, based on your GPA and your test scores. So if you apply with test scores, this is the scholarship chart that we will use. These are automatic scholarships, essentially where your GPA and your test score meet on the chart. If it falls into any one of those 5 colored areas of the grid, you will receive an academic scholarship from us. You can see the different colors correlate to different money amounts, different levels of scholarships, and you can see that at the top. If you are falling into levels 1, 2, or 3, and you are admitted into certain programs, they are listed there on the left, you will also receive an automatic departmental scholarship on top of the centralized award. And then one final note for this chart, if you are a resident of West Virginia and you fall into the level 1 category and you are admitted by early January, you will receive an application to apply for the Bucklew and Foundation Scholarship. The Bucklew Scholarship is valued at $10,000 per year, and we award 20 of those scholarships each year. Out of those 20 recipients, we select 5 to receive our most prestigious scholarship, the Foundation Scholarship, which covers your complete cost of attendance, plus an academic enhancement grant it covers your cost of attendance for over 4 years. The Statler College of Engineering and Mineral Resources also offers additional automatic scholarships. They just use a little bit modified version of this chart. They look at your GPA, your test score, and then the math portion of your SAT or ACT. If you have not had a chance to take the SAT or ACT, you can indicate that yes, you would like to apply test optional. We would then just need the application and your official transcript or self-reported transcript. We will base our decision on your cumulative freshman through junior GPA. There are some programs, however, that do require some sort of secondary assessment. So they need additional information beyond GPA, but keeping in mind that you've not been able to take the SAT or ACT. So the two examples that I like to give are engineering and nursing. So engineering, you can be admitted to general engineering based on your GPA, but then we'll need to either take our placement exam, submit AP scores in math, dual enrollment courses in math to fully be admitted into the program. If you apply test optional into nursing, regardless of GPA, you will be admitted into what's called the Health and Well-Being program. You will then, prior to December 1st for priority consideration, need to submit scores from the TEAS test. That will determine your eligibility for the nursing program. What's really nice about our test optional policy is that once you apply test optional, you're not locked into that decision. You can, at any point, submit test scores for review. We are using what's called a no harm policy, though. So if you submit scores that do not benefit you, meaning they do not raise your scholarship to the next level or make you admissible for a program that you previously were not, we will not use the scores. So essentially, submitting scores cannot hurt you once you've been admitted test optional, but it is an option to submit those for the MAC scholarship consideration. These are the scholarships that we'll be awarding if a student applies test optional. So you can see it's going to be based on, again, your freshman through junior cumulative GPA, and you can see the different levels there. These are, again, automatic. However, if you are applying test optional and eligible for our Go First scholarship, you are not, however, eligible for our departmental scholarships. So one last quiz question here. True or false? I should wait until I have my ideal test score to apply to WVU to make sure I receive the most scholarship possible, the highest scholarship possible. That is correct. So it is false. So I mentioned that once you apply test optional, you can apply test optional rather if you don't have your scores yet. So you don't have to have them to apply. Even if you have taken the SAT or ACTs, you can still submit your scores now, apply now, and if you're admissible, you still have until our scholarship deadline to submit updated test scores. So don't think that you have to wait until you kind of have that ideal number that you're aiming for. We do continue to reevaluate as test scores are received. Now, one other thing in addition to scholarships will happen automatically for all students who are admitted, and that is that you'll be evaluated for the Honors College. So both test optional admits as well as students who apply with test scores will be considered for the Honors College. If you meet the criteria, you will receive an invitation in the mail. And if you want to accept that, you just send a short personal statement back. There are a lot of really great resources and benefits that come with being part of the Honors College. Starting your second semester at WVU, you get priority course registration, where you register before pretty much anyone else on campus. So it really makes it nice to get elective courses, your preferred time of day, and so on. You have great honors advisors, mentors within the program. There is honors only housing available to our students. And you also have early move-in your first year, which can be a really nice benefit. So for those of you who have been admitted, or maybe you plan to apply and just want to know kind of what to expect, every student who is admitted, we encourage them to claim their account. There will be information in this on how to do this in the information that you receive once you've been admitted. Claiming your account does not in any way obligate you to attend or tell us that you plan to attend. This claiming your account gives you access to your student portal, which is where you can start to check your WVU email. Many departments on campus, such as financial aid and housing, will email you at that email address once you've been admitted. So it is important to check that on a regular basis to make sure that you're not missing any important information. The student portal is, however, where you will take the first step if you decide that you are ready to enroll, and that is submitting the academic deposit. The academic deposit is $150 for residents and $250 for non-residents. It tells us that you plan to attend, and it also allows you to proceed with the housing process. The academic deposit is fully refundable up until May 1st, should you decide to change your mind. Once your academic deposit is on file, you are able to proceed with selecting housing. If you live within 50 miles of Morgantown, you do have the option to commute from home, living with your parent or guardian. However, if you are outside of that commuting radius, it is required that you live on campus. The FAFSA is incredibly important, and we encourage every student in West Virginia to complete the FAFSA. That is the free application for federal student aid. It is what's going to start the financial aid process and determine your eligibility for grants, loans, work studies, and even if you would do federal loans, hopefully you can get a subsidized versus an unsubsidized loan. You'll want to complete that as early as possible to give you time to make any corrections or go through the verification process if you are selected. Students who have been admitted and have a valid FAFSA on file will start to receive financial aid packages late December, early January. And so then again, the earlier you have it on file, the more time you'll have to review your financial aid package and determine if we are a good fit for you financially. And then this is a little bit far removed, but we do get a lot of questions about it. You will not schedule your classes until next summer at new student orientation. So you'll receive more information on that in the spring. While we hope that this session answered all of your questions about the university, we do encourage you to check out some of our other virtual options. We do hope to have in-person campus tours resumed closer to the end of the year, but that is pending a lot of different things. So right now everything is virtual. We have our virtual campus tours as well as numerous other events that you can use to learn more about a prospective major or resource on campus. The website there, if you are not already on our mailing list or you would like to update the information that we have on file, you can go to that website and enter your information. We will send you periodic updates, information about academics and events going on campus. So with that, I would like to share, this is the contact information for the three of us that are on the panel today. Our contact information is there, as well as you can see the different counties that we represent. So it's very easy. You just find your county, and then that is your assigned regional recruiter. So with that, we would like to open it up to any questions that you have. And you can put those in the Q&A box. Now, we want to tell you, don't go anywhere, though, because after we answer questions, we will see who our winner was from our trivia contest. So again, you can ask questions in the Q&A box. We will answer those as best as we can. If we would happen to get a lot of questions, we will follow up with you after. We have about a little less than 10 minutes before our session is over.
I guess we did a great job with our presentation. Everyone's questions have been answered.
Yeah, I agree, Rochelle. I don't see any. Oh, we did have a question coming in. Do you allow pets? We do have policies if it is a registered service animal that you can work with housing. But typically, if it's just, you know, your pet cat from home, they would not allow that. But we do have policies for registered service animals.
Well, no one has asked this question. It's a common one that we get about vehicles on campus. So you are allowed to bring a car as a first-time freshman. However, we don't really recommend it because it tends to be perhaps more trouble than it's worth. You're not going to be driving among the three areas of campus typically. And it's about $262, I believe, for a parking permit up near the law school. So if it's essential to you, that is an option. But again, we don't really recommend it.
It looks like we have another question coming in. What should my major be for occupational therapy?
And I'll take that question. The recommended major is exercise physiology. Students get practical experience. Students have access to the human cadaver lab, which is important for someone going into a health profession. However, if you enjoy biology, you think you might prefer biochemistry, there are other majors, as long as they're science-based, that will help prepare you for a professional program like occupational therapy. But you probably want to look into exercise physiology, at least initially.
And Christina, if you want to take this, what is the process to request a single person dorm?
Yeah, of course. You can actually indicate that on your housing application when you're completing it. But then, most importantly, when you do finish your housing application, submit that housing deposit, and you enter the housing portal, you actually get to choose your own dorm room. So you get to navigate amongst the single dorms that are available to students. And so again, it's first come, first serve basis. So if you do have a dorm in mind or you do want a single person dorm room, I do recommend doing that as soon as you can. You can also choose to contact us if you need help with that process, and we'll work with housing with you, but you actually will do that on your own within the housing portal.
And the next question is, maybe Danielle, you'd like to take this. What major would you do for occupation and social work? So what major would you recommend for social work?
Yeah, that's a great question. So we are fortunate at WVU that we actually have a social work bachelor's and master's program. So students who want to work in that field, and really social work, I was amazed when I started learning a little bit more about it. There are so many different areas that you can work in within social work, and our program does prepare you to go out into really just about any of those. So if you are interested in social work, you can actually declare that program on your application.
As Christina said earlier, we would be glad to connect you with representatives from the different colleges and different academic areas. So if you would like to have a more in-depth conversation, we have a lot of folks who are willing to talk with you and actually recruitment specialists for each of our 14 different colleges at WVU. So, but if anybody does have other majors you're considering, feel free to let us know about those. I think we have about 5 minutes remaining. Any other questions?
No, and it looks like Christina is here unveiling our winner of the trivia contest.
Congratulations, Corey.
Yeah, Corey, congratulations.
Nice job, Allie and Polly as well.
Well, great job. And we do have one more question. So someone is asking about pre-vet studies. Would anybody like to answer that question?
Yeah, absolutely. I don't mind taking that. So we have our animal and nutritional sciences program, and that is the recommended pre-vet program. We actually have a program within that degree called the Davis-Michael Scholars Program, where other veterinary schools save seats for West Virginia residents who have gone through that program. So it really gives you a nice advantage when it comes time to applying to veterinary school. You are correct that there is no veterinary school within the state of West Virginia. So you can do your pre-vet program, so that animal and nutritional sciences program at WVU, but then you would go on to either one of the graduate programs within the Davis-Michaels program or any veterinary school across the country.
Just to add on, we have a wonderful animal science farm right outside of Morgantown. So,
and I believe our average is over 70% of students who WVU graduates from that program who apply to vet school and get admitted, which is well over the national average. We have a few minutes left. If anyone else has a question, we'd be happy to answer. Well, if there are no other questions, please feel free to reach out to us. Any of us can help you. We can put you in touch with the right representative, and we would love to help you learn more about WVU programs of studies, scholarships, student life, anything you'd like to know. We would be glad to help you with throughout the enrollment and the application process.
Well, thank you very much, ladies, for your time this evening and providing that information on West Virginia University. We thank everybody for attending with us this evening. A couple of final housekeeping remarks. Once you exit out of your, there's going to be a survey, a four-question survey. If you would please be willing to do that for us so we can improve in any way. If you would like to sign up for any more sessions on any more institutions throughout West Virginia and really throughout the country, you can do so by, again, going to www.wvacrao.org/student-access. And again, the sessions will be recorded, and those can be accessed at wvacrao.org as well. Thank you and have a good evening.